Hi, it's me, Ann Farabee. Hide and seek. No doubt we have all participated in a game of hide and seek. Everyone knows the rules. It counts aloud to a pre-selected number like 10 while everyone hides. It then says something like, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 10, ready or not, here I come. It begins looking for the people who are hiding. The word look is different from the word seek. To look means to see or to pay attention to. To seek means to go in search of something. If you are playing with children age 5 or under and you are it, finding those who are hiding while playing outdoors can be pretty simple. Look around, stand still, listen for whispering, giggling, and rustling sounds. Walk toward those sounds. As it, I never let the children know that I know where they are. I make a huge scene while slamming doors and wondering aloud, where in the world could they be hiding? Then I make loud announcements like, I think I'll go look in the kitchen. I bet he's hiding in there. There was this one time though, one little hider had not been located. I looked everywhere. Looking everywhere was not successful, for I was only looking with my eyes. I needed to seek for him. I had to search for him. I knew he had to be near, so I called out his name. No answer. I noticed a blanket on the floor of the closet I had looked in earlier. This time, I decided to lift up the blanket to search for him. There he was, safe, secure, and soundly sleeping. Seeking him had mattered. Looking for him had not been enough. Did God's word mention hide and seek? Well, Adam and Eve hid from God, but God knew exactly where they were. Jonah hid from God and ended up in the belly of the whale. God is our hiding place. Psalm 119, verse 114. We are to seek him while he may be found. Isaiah 55:6. Hiding from God? Impossible. He knows exactly where we are. Let's seek him while he may be found.